Pinky Mishra from BHU Department of Philosophy and Religion. Today I am presenting my paper Exploring the Nature of Consciousness in Buddhism, Special Reference of Vijnanavada. Yogacara, another name for Vijnanavada, became a prominent Mahayana school of thought. Beyond the early Buddhist analysis, its founder, Asanga and Vasubandhu, created a comprehensive awareness theory. The basic idea of Vijnanavada is that the mind is the source of all reality and that our perception of the outside world is just a projection of it. This paper contained that the Vijnanavada school of Buddhism, which hold that all things are projection of the mind and that enlightenment results realizing this principle by meditation and moral behavior, gives a distinctive and profound understanding of consciousness through an analysis of the eight consciousness, the three natures, and the consciousness transformation. This paper seeks to show how Vijnanavada understanding of consciousness offer useful insight for both traditional and contemporary application in attaining mental clarity and spiritual insight. Throughout history, consciousness has been the basis theme of many philosophical and the spiritual tradition. Buddhism offers deep insight into the inner working of the mind and the road to enlightenment through the nuanced and in-depth exploration of the nature of awareness. The Vijnanavadi school of Buddhism, sometimes referred to as the Yogacara or consciousness only school, provides a unique and complex interpretation of consciousness among the various schools of Buddhism. This school challenges our conventional ideas of reality and the self by arguing that what we see as the outside world is a mental projection. Buddhism usually categorizes consciousness into six main categories, each of which corresponds to a certain sensory modality. The framework of Vijnanavada is expanded by incorporating two new types of consciousness: the storehouse consciousness, Alaya Vijnana, and the troubled mind, Klesha Manas. This modification offered through model theory describes the underlying mechanism that influences our perception and behaviors in addition to accounting for sensory experience. This paper aims to investigate the nature of consciousness in Buddhism, specifically focusing on the Yogacara school. Vijnana or consciousness is a central idea in Buddhism and is closely related to our knowledge of the mind, perception, and cognitive process. It is believed that consciousness is a composite of entity. According to the traditional Buddhist framework, consciousness is classified into six main categories, asada vijnana, each of which is linked to a specific sensory modality and mental ability. Now I will explain six type of consciousness in Buddhist philosophy called Sad Vijnana. First one is acknowledgement of vision, Chakshur Vijnana. When the eye, a sense organ, comes into contact with an observable shape, a sense object, and the associated visual capacity, a sense consciousness is created. The experience of seeing is the result of this interaction. According to Buddhist theory, visual consciousness is transient and contingent, appearing only when certain pursuits are satisfied. Second is cortical awareness, Srot Vijnanavada. Similar to other sense organ, auditory consciousness arises when the ear sense object dictates sound. This the experience of hearing is the outcome of this. Like all forms of consciousness, auditory consciousness is fleeting and depend on how these sense organ interact with the object. Perceptual awareness, Grand Vijnanavada, is third. This kind of consciousness arises from the interaction between smell and the nose. The ability to smell is facilitated by olfactory awareness. It is a transient and contingent upon the circumstances surrounding the sensory exchanges. And fourth is the obligatory consciousness, or Jiva Vijnana. The relationship between taste and the tongue gives rise to gustatory consciousness. Tasting is the experience that arises from this kind of consciousness because it is dependent upon the presence of both sense organ and the sense object. It emphasizes the Buddhist idea of conditionality. Fifth is the touch sensibility, Kava Vijnana. Tactile consciousness is created when the body comes into the contact with physical tongue. The feeling of touch is the outcome of this contact. Tactile consciousness also believed to be transient, appearing under certain circumstances and disappearing when those circumstances alter. Sixth and last is the mind awareness, Mano Vijnana. Since mental consciousness originates from the mind, मनस एंड मेंटल लॉजिक धर्म. इट डिफर फ्रॉम द अदर फाइव कैटेगरीज ऑफ कॉन्सियसनेस. इट इंक्लूड कॉन्सेप्ट आइडियाज एंड मेंटल प्रोसेसेस. मेंटल कॉन्सियसनेस इज एसेंशियल टू कॉग्निटिव प्रोसेसेस बिकॉज इट ऑर्गेनाइजेस एंड इंटरप्रेट सेंसरी डाटा. इन कंट्रास्ट टू द अदर फॉर्म मेंटल अवेयरनेस कैन ओरिजिनेट स्पॉन्टेनियसली फ्रॉम इंटरनल मेंटल एक्टिविटी विदाउट एक्सटर्नल स्टिमुली. द बेसिस ऑफ आइडिया ऑफ विज्ञानवाद इज द माइंड इज द सोर्स ऑफ ऑल रियालिटी. And that our perception of the outside world is just as a perception of it. Now I will discuss the veracity of consciousness in a Vijnanavada. The first one is Alaya Vijnana. The central idea of Yogacharya or Vijnanavada school of Mahayana Buddhism is Alaya Vijnana. Therefore, it's just that the ultimate foundation of the seeming individual is a greater stored consciousness. The universe is made up of an endless supply of potency of thought that are stored up and remain dormant, while that latent consciousness is in a restless flux until the karma of accumulated consequences of past deeds is destroyed. It projects an interpreted stream of ideas. All of the impression from the past experience are stored in the storehouse consciousness, which is an elusive energy that generates categories that are merely fiction and contain the seeds of future karmic addition. The elusive energy called Maya is part of human nature and controls the universe of difference, giving rise to false concept of an I and a non-I. Only enlightenment bodhi, which make a person a Buddha, can overcome that duality. Now I will come to the next point of consciousness, Trishobhavada. Parikalpit Sobhavada, Paritantra Sobhavada, Parinispanna Sobhavada. Parikalpit Sobhavada, the term imaginary or impure nature describe how things are mistakenly understood to be entities that they exist independently of the consciousness that experiences them. It should be noted that according to the Yogacara analysis, objects are created from seeds that are present in the eight awareness are Alaya Vijnana and do not exist independently of the perceiving subject. But because of ignoring, subject and object are thought to be distinct from one and another. Pratantra Subhavada, the common knowledge that all subject and object depend on causes and conditions to exist in known as the dependent nature of thing. Put differently, nothing transient can create itself. Parinispanna Subhavada, the non-duality between consciousness and their object is referred to as the complete nature. It speaks specifically of the lack of an object distinct from the awareness that seeks it. It might be seen as a reality, perfected nature. Another point is Vigyapti Matrata, which is also related to consciousness. Consciousness only is what the Vigyapti Matra alludes to. For Yogacara, however, there is reality that transcends Dravisat or casually existence. It impetiness or consciousness alone that is the knowledge that the actual reality is devoid of imagined object parikalpita. Instead different, the ultimate truth is the cognition exists alone and that nothing outside of it. Correspondent to it, this realm is unfathomable and exclusive to the enlightened supernatural cognition. The practical consequences of Vijnanavada is theoretical understanding of consciousness extended to spiritual practice, realizing the genuine nature of awareness and overcoming mental illusion in the ultimate. The attainment of Buddhahood and the end of suffering result from the realization. In the Vijnanavada tradition, meditation techniques center are realizing the true nature of the mind and concerning its illusion. To develop a direct experience awareness of the nature of consciousness and to obtain insight into how it functions, practices like mindfulness and concentration are used. Compensation and moral behavior are fostered by an awareness of the interdependence of consciousness, being aware of how all beings are related to one another and how consciousness serves their experience, promotes kindness and generosity. In Vijnanavada, this ethical component is essential to the route to enlightenment. The sum of the paper, by questioning accepted conception of reality and highlighting the role that the mind plays in shaping our experience. The Vijnanavada school of Buddhism provides a deep and complex understanding of consciousness. Vijnanavada illuminates the interdependence of all occurrence and the possibility of attaining a more profound non-dual knowledge by delving into the nature of consciousness and offering insightful perspective on the route to spiritual liberation. In addition to depending on knowledge of Buddhist philosophy, this investigation provides helpful advice for individuals pursuing the path of Dharma to improve their thought and their lives. Thank you.